In this video, I'm going to show you examples of cover images on stores that I like on Redbubble. I'm also going to show you how to make your own cover images in Canva and Affinity Designer. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I want to teach you how to make cover images for your Redbubble shop. So if you're on Redbubble, you've probably seen these on stores. It's the top part of your store. And this is where I think you can add a lot of elements about your products that you're selling below. I'm going to show you in this video some of the cover images that I like from different stores and how to make these ones. I'm going to show you how to make the ones that I found really easily in Canva. So you can do it on free for Canva, or if you have Affinity Designer, you can do it there too. I'll show you both ways. Pretty simple to do. The hardest part is to get the image size right, and I'm going to show you where to find that and where to change your cover images on Redbubble. So let's go to Redbubble first and then go to Canva. So here we are on Redbubble, redbubble.com. I'm on my Explore page. Yours may look different depending on what you looked at or what you like. I'm gonna show you some of my favorite shop banners or my favorite cover images on their shop. And here's Illustrata. So you can see they have their nice artwork on here, but if you look at it, it's just three of their artworks. You can see this one, and this one, right? If you look at EduEli, I had both of these on my interview if you want to check out their videos. But EduEli, also three of his designs, right? Really big. The difference here in Edu's one is he actually put his logo in the middle one here and kind of made it darker in the background. The next shop that I want to show you here is Laurel. You can see this one is four designs. So you can see the kind of the theme here is we're just taking the designs that you have and just putting it in the shop banner. And here's another one, Vincent Trinidad. So 1, 2, 3, 4. You could do that as well. This one is using 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then with a banner on the bottom instead of a logo, kind of what the name of the shop is. It's really smart to do that. But you can see this fits really nicely. Here is another version. You could take your t-shirt designs, your mock-up designs that are on Placeit, and then put it here. So all of these are from Placeit. They put the design here and then they just put it on their banner, right? And then lastly, I think this one is really cool. If you sell a lot of stickers, I would say do this like this. Put your name in the middle here, whatever way you want to do it. And then, you know, kind of create a collage of your stickers just all around. You can see it can kind of break the border here. It doesn't have to be right to the edge. So use that. I think that would be really cool if you have a sticker shop or have designs like this where there's no border and stuff. I think this is really cool. So those are the kinds of designs that I'm going to show you how to make in Canva and in Affinity Designer. But first, let me show you where you put them and how to find the size. So let's go back to Redbubble here. I'm going to go to my dashboard. And then after your dashboard, go here to Edit Profile. And then this is the cover image. Now you can choose your avatar, whatever that is. I can show you how to make that later. But today, cover image, and we're going to do 2400 pixels by 600 pixels, okay? So that's very important. Write that down. And we're going to go into Canva and make a design that size. So here we are on Canva. Let's do Canva first. Canva.com right here. Let's create a design. So first, we do this. Custom size. We're going to do 2400 by 600, that's the cover image size for Redbubble, right? So click on here. If you don't have it as recent, I did a recent one, you can just type in here, 2400 by 600, boom, create it. So you can see right away two things happen. You have the right size right here, and for the templates, you can see they are suggesting a whole bunch of templates. So if you don't know what to do and you want something really quick, you're just starting off and you have no designs at all in your shop, come here, make this design, and then you know you can pick something like this and just change it. Let's say it's the fun shop or whatever your name of your shop is, right? You can change it. Or if you don't like this one, come over here and maybe it's this one instead. Replace current image. Look at that. There's just so many here. This one's really cool. I think this, like, if you don't know what you're going to design yet, this is still really nice. And you can do, you know, your name here, whatever your shop name is here, and then what you sell below it. So right here, you can say, Custom stickers, if you do stickers or whatever it is, right? And t-shirts. Let's see, and shirts or whatever you want to call it. And you can change the color on some of these things too. So if you don't like this color background, come in here just like Canva and, you know, change it to something else, right? Just really fun. And then if this doesn't work on a light color, of course, you can change the text to something light. Look at that. Really cool, right? So again, like if you don't want it, there's a ton of them just right here. Look at that. That is so cool, right? So if you're first starting out, Redbubble, come over here, real easy, and then you can just download this. Now let me show you how to add your artwork. So let's say you're on here and you want to do something like you saw before, like I was showing you some of them where it's like there's three of them or four of them or six of them. Now you can come in here, just start from blank, and maybe you want a dark background, black, and then come into your uploads. Now I uploaded a bunch of my things here. I'm doing like a Shirttober. If you follow me on the social medias, you know that I'm doing t-shirts. And these are some of the ones that I've done here. And it's real easy. You just hit upload file and upload that PNG file that you're going to use for designs. That's all this is. These are the PNG files that you're going to use for putting it on Redbubble or Merch by Amazon or whatever. And then we can just grab this, click on it, and you can see it's perfect on here and you can scale it. Now, if you want a certain background on here, let's say you want this one in blue, come in here to elements and use lines and shapes and just pick this square. And let's say we want this here, boom, boom, like that, and put it in the back. So right click and send to back. And there you go. So I'm gonna show you a little trick on how you can make this, you know, three wide or four wide or whatever it is. So let's click the background again. Hold down Option and drag it so you can see it's right here. Let's butt it up against here. Make this a different color so that you can see it. And then, so that's too wide. So if you wanted too wide, well, none of them were too wide. I think one of them was three. So let's do another one here. Option, click, drag, change the color. You know, maybe this one's black or, well, we can't see that. Let's do this color. And now just grab all three and then you can see this is three equally spaced, right? Now you don't have to worry if this goes over. You can always come in here, click on this, and then size it down if you want to. But this is three. Now if you wanted four, you would come in here, you know, grab all of them again, and then kind of shrink it down, but put another one here, you know, four, and maybe change this back to a blue or something. You know, and now it's four, and now you can make these taller. So let's come in here, and then now you know they're evenly spaced, four evenly spaced, right? And now you can put in whatever ones you want. So let me put in some of the other ones on here. I'll go back to my uploads. Let's say I want this one here, you know, and then maybe this game day one I like, whatever it is, maybe that's here. And then distracted by cats here, right? And the nice thing about doing it in Canva and having the background is you can change the color of these. So let's say we want this one with a black background and maybe this one with a, I don't know, let's try a different color, you know, like that, or a gray, or this one, you know, you can play around with it, right? And so there you go. And then you just export this, whatever you come up with, you can export it here, go to share, and hit download, and now you can see it's 2400 by 600, and then you don't need the transparent background, so you can do this for free, and just hit download, and when you download, you can upload this back onto Redbubble right there on that page. Now, the way to do the freestyle one is, of course, let's do this again. Let's say we had the sticker one that we wanted to do. We'll go back to templates. Look for one that has a name in the middle here, you know, maybe like this. And then we can take out these things, change your name, your shop name here, and then just go back to uploads. And if you have your stickers in here, maybe it's like this where your stickers, you know, and put them and you can turn them and things like that. So let's say this is another sticker. You could come in here and turn it, things like that, right? And this will be really cool. Imagine these are different stickers and you just kind of put it here and there, right? So that's also a nice tip to do for your design for your shop. So lots of different ways to do this on Canva. You got a lot of different templates as well. Play around with these. I mean, some of these have some really cool graphics on them. So let's just do this, like, you know, some cool stuff like that. Or if you want to put pictures, maybe this is where you put your place it pictures and things like that. So, and some really cool watercolor stuff. So if you're drawing into watercolor but you haven't done anything yet, you got this here, and you can try them out. Try out different ones. And of course you can add pages here to kind of see, do I like this one better or this one better, right? So that's how you do it on Canva, real easy. Let me show you how to do it in Affinity Designer. If you have Affinity Designer, I'll go there now. So here we are in Affinity Designer. I started a new document here. Now you're gonna have to change this layout to 2400 by 600 pixels. So I have it already here. It doesn't have to be 300 DPI, but it can be, it doesn't matter. Probably just leave it if you have it already there, and then hit create. And then we're gonna see this size right here. I'm gonna scroll up so you can see it. So you can see it's 2400 by 600 pixels if you're on the transform palette right there. And then I'm gonna use the rectangle tool here, and then I'm gonna make my rectangle 600 by 600. We're gonna do a square here. So double click on there, 600, tab, 600, tab. Click on your move tool, and then we can move this using these right here, the alignment. Click on here, make sure that it's left aligned and then centered. You can see it fits right there. And then we can color these. So, you know, make it a orange color. We don't need the stroke here. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna make four of them. So option, hold, drag, and we can do this again. Boom, center, make this center, and then just butt it up against this one. So let's do this a different color so you can see, whoops, right here so you can see it. Hold down shift so it doesn't move. Boom, and then this can be a different color as well. Hold down shift so it doesn't move. And there you go. So we can put our four designs here as well, like we saw before. We can also do some really cool stuff with, I didn't show the other time, is we can make these 8x8, right? So let's do this. So instead of 600, it could be 300. I should have typed this in, 300, tab, 300, tab. And we can do this one top and bottom. Let's do side and bottom. So you can see those two there. Let's just move these. So now we know these two are right. Kind of hold down option and shift and kind of butt it up right there. And then we can use J, command J, to kind of just put it all the way. And it's not exactly right. So let's move this one up against here. And then if it's not right, what you can do is you can select all of these. Whoops. If it's not right, you can select all of these here and go to align and then align this one, space horizontally, same thing with this. And this is how I did my version. Come here and space it out like that. And then change these to different colors, right? I'm just gonna select these real quick. And then maybe those are black or whatever. I mean, they can be any color you want. It doesn't have to be black and orange, but that's appropriate for Halloween. And then drag in your designs here. So let's do one. I have some of these here. Let's make pretend these are t-shirt designs. I have them. You can come in here, command V, copy, and then just put them in here, right? Like that, right? And I'm gonna just grab this whole thing, copy. Right, and then we're gonna have to size this down. And then we can start putting these in here like that, right? Just pretend that they're the right size. And of course you could size them and stuff like that. So another thing you could do is let's undo all of this. I'm hitting Command Z to undo. If you wanted just one color like this and put your name, we saw that collage. We can do the same thing here, right? You know, maybe a bunch of these like this. And we'll come back here, Command V, And maybe, did I size this right? Yeah, so you can size it down like that, you know, and if you have like a thicker one, let's go back. I think a bunch of them were down here, right? And turn them just like that one that we saw with the stickers, right? And then you can type in your name here, right? Boom, use the text tool to type in your shop name. Shop name, boom. And then whatever else you want to put in here, it can be a different font or whatever. So there, that's how you do it. Just real simple. If you want the boxes, you can. Just use math to kind of figure it out and then use this align tool to figure it out. And you can have your designs bigger or smaller. It will work just as fine. So next thing you would do here in Affinity Designer is click on your artboard, go to export right here, and then export this as a PNG. Make sure it's the 2400 by 600, and then hit export, and then that PNG will be brought into Redbubble, and it can be your cover art. So hopefully it didn't go too fast for you guys here. If you wanna see this in more detail or want a different kind of shop banner, shop or cover image is what they call it, let me know in the comments. If you see one that you really like and want to know how to do it, I can show you how to do it in Affinity Designer or Canva. Either one would work. And you could also do it in Photopea if that's what you have. It's just real easy to do. The main thing is to make sure to get it at that right size and then put all your stuff in there and have fun with this. So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you, and now you can make your own shop banners or cover images for Redbubble. If you haven't had one already, if you want to redo yours, this is a real easy way to do it. If this video is really helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, what cover image is your favorite on Redbubble? Have you seen one? If it's one that I showed already on this video, or if it's one that you've seen before, let me know that in the comments. I'd love to see different cover images for Redbubble shops. Thanks again for watching, and if you want to see more Redbubble tutorials, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.